Okay, guys, today we are going to be looking at more of your notes. I had my viewers submit screenshots of random notes from their notes app. We already did part one, this is part two, and we got so many submissions. I don't even know if we're going to be able to get through all of them this time, but let's just start looking. All right, we are picking right back up where we left off. What is this hidden talent? I can make my toes look like elbow noodles. I was gonna say I wonder what that looks like, but I actually really don't wonder at all, and I really don't wanna know either. Oh my, whoa. Duck you, Bert, you're a little piece of shirt. Wow. Okay, future baby names, let's judge. Girls, Luna. Is it pronounced cello? Cielo? Mia? Maya? Violet? Miracle? Annalise? Valentina? Okay, if you name your child Valentina, like, they're gonna be an ally. Skylar? Blossom? Rosalind? Chloe? Kinsley? Milani? Stella? Emery? Noah? Ethan? Calvin? Caden? Oh, all of those boys are gonna be f boys. Like, I'm a full believer in, like, names, I think, affect your life. Names affect your life. They affect how you, who you're gonna turn into. I really fully think that. Is this one of you guys?
Who is this?
Normalize context. We need context here. Might suck, might suck. This was mine. Oh, what's the context? We have the person in the stream, you guys. It was about coming out. Okay, might suck. Oh, no pros? Oh, whose dog is that? Dressed as a hot dog. The geyser? Did you stay here? The shark motel? Cute, awesome baby names. Okay, oh. Salvia. Euthanasia. Clark. Wait, cause I get this. I actually get this. And I see the vision. I'm really liking Salvia. And euthanasia goes, yeah. Youth for short. Youth. Salvia's actually cute. Salvia's actually a cute name. I thought that said sativa at first. I did too, which, speaking of, that could be another good name, you guys. Sativa? You actually know an indica. That's a good, that is a good name for twins. Sativa and indica. Oh my God. And if you have triplets, sativa, indica, and hybrid. Hello? Wait, I had to write this down. Little critter fellas with the tails and they wiggle around my room. Who? I looked at the chat, someone said mice? Rats? Jizz pod, jizz nation. Okay, wait, so this is obviously what you're thinking about for your podcast, the jizz pod, and then you call your listeners the jizz nation. I see the vision. You did a little research, I see gay slang serving similar to serving realness. Serving content takes serving realness to the next level. It's pussy power, bold, to the point, and overall extravagant. Any gender is able to serve content. It's a mindset. A little cheat sheet. A little cheat sheet in your notes app. Just in case, like, you forget, you know, you forget your gay slang. Pull up your cheat sheet. Bros making a dictionary is crazy. Oh my God, another note about baby names. Christian. What is going on? This would be good. Okay, we've got a list of jokes here. Looks like there's only one entry though. Poutine these nuts in your mouth. Okay, I see this person is probably Canadian. Are you guys saying this up there in Canada? Cause this is pretty good, I have to be honest. Like, I know Canadians, you guys are getting poutine a lot. There's plenty of opportunities to be using this joke. What do you mean they need to go to jail? Is that my wig? I have this wig. It's the 10-minute wig. Corn nuggets, fruity pebbles, potato skins, mozzarella sticks, Foof City cookies, lactate milk, stuff for chicken fajitas, a different kind of frozen pizza, more hash browns, fruit bowl. Okay, this is your grocery list. Corn nuggets, what is that? Why is it at the top of the list for groceries? What is that? I've actually never heard of that before. Oh? I was not expecting this at all. There are like a fried snack? I was not picturing this in my head. Okay, I'm not a corn fan, but actually, I feel like if you did like corn, it might be good. Dog names, Alfredo, Ravioli, Rigatoni, Wellington. And then I like that you have the nicknames because your dog needs a nickname, right? Al, Ollie, Tony, Beef. This is a good one. Wellington and Beef. My favorite dog name from this list though, I think I like Ravioli. Ravioli, that's cute. I love when you guys take a picture of a phone screen. Day 11, something on my bucket list. Be a pro dancer. Okay, you wrote this in 2014, so I would love to hear the update now. It's been almost 10 years. How's it going on the dancing career? It's going good right now. I've been working hard recently. I don't know if you actually are the person who submitted this, but I'm just gonna pretend that you are. So I'm glad to hear that. Oh, is this, I can tell this is also from the same person because this is giving it away right here. Hashtag squatting ballerinas. Squatting. What were you putting that on? Oh my God, it's the same person. I can tell. Bucket list. Go to Disney World, meet Bethany Moda, visit Hollywood, be a pro dancer. I need updates. Are you a pro dancer? Ooh. Okay. Okay. When can I see your face? I gander at your toes. They wriggle a bit in tiny little rows. So petite and small, a deluge to see. Under your feet is where I should be. Longing of me heart, the tightness of chest is cause of your feet and not your chest. Star in de sky, your eye de glisten, make wit the soft, my heart will listen. Still you ask me, I admit defeat. What I really like, I say your feet. The only thing that's making this like a little bit okay is the fact that it was written in April of 2020. Okay. We were all losing our minds back then. Oh, also, and the time, 2:51 a.m. This explains a lot. This really explains a lot about this, but I don't know, like, I'm just gonna go to the next one. Ooh, okay. Baby's pros and cons list. I'm really interested in this. Pros. Sometimes cute, big eyes, chubby little shits. What the fuck? Oh, like you're saying the babies are chubby. Oh my God. I literally read that as like you're talking about their shits. Oh my God. That had me literally, like, I did not know what to say next. Oh, okay. Rules if I'm ever in a coma. Shave my legs once in a while, thank you. No forests. Okay, yeah. Eating tube must be healthy for the body. Audiobooks, podcasts, and good music to keep me entertained. Hospitals are boring. Yes, and apparently when you're in a coma, you can hear what's going on. You can hear when people are talking to you and stuff. So I'm sure you could hear the audiobook, the podcast, and the good music, you know? That's very important. Start a GoFundMe so we can go on a vacay when I wake up. Facials so I can have flawless skin when I wake up. Yes, yes. Keep track of who visits me. Say they're real ones for real. Okay, yeah, I actually want to know this as well. Who's visiting? Who's coming in and visiting? And how many times as well? I want to know. This is really valid, yeah. I think we all need to, like, you know, be a little prepared for, like, the worst case scenario. Reasons to call off work. You're lying regardless of which you pick. You just have to choose. That's just a little reminder. Cat died. Whoa. Pros, won't ask for proof. You're lying regardless. Might as well make it a good one. Cons, kind of vulgar. Might tell me to suck it up. No, I think the con here, the major con here is like karma. I think when you're lying about like an excuse, I don't think you can say that anyone died, especially anyone that's like actually alive or like a pet or something. That's bad karma. Also like bad manifestation, like putting that out into the universe is just too spooky and haunted for me. Can't get car out of the driveway. Weather permitted. Yeah, okay, so this needs to be, the weather needs to be right for this. Pros, snow is melting. Cons, what if they offer to pick me up? Whoa. Yeah, this one could go wrong. Car won't start. Pros, nothing. Cons, could also offer to pick me up. Same deal. Have a migraine. Pros, no proof needed. Cons, might say too bad, so sad. That's true. Like a lot of times you guys, you gotta keep living life when you have a migraine. This is me today, okay? I have a migraine today. Did I call out sick from Twitch? No. Threw up. Pros, they don't wanna see proof for that. Yep. Same with diarrhea. Like, okay, I feel like saying food poisoning or like I can't stop shitting myself. That's the best excuse to call off from work. I'm having explosive diarrhea, can't stop shitting myself. You know, no one's gonna ask for proof for that, and no one will think you're lying about it because it is really hard to, it's hard to admit that. It's hard to be open and be like, I'm shitting myself nonstop. Like, who's gonna actually admit that? Itchy, gitchy, ya, da, da. Itchy, gitchy, ya. Yes! Wait, are these real lyrics? Wait, we just got Christ in notes app form. Okay, so we got a little to-do list here for work. And then a little manifestation moment. My haircut today will look amazing. Over and over again. Manifestation. I hope you are writing this with your crystals. Have your crystals taped to your thumbs. One crystal on each thumb to type this out. Yep, that's how you get it done. Lifeless spoon that always tries to get in your mouth. This is really like, I was trying to analyze this for a second. I hope you don't run into one of my exes at the 29th annual Berkeley Springs International Water Tasting. Because I have multiple. You have multiple exes going to the 29th annual Berkeley Springs International Water Tasting? The Grim Reaper kissed Joe on the mouth. What is going on in low power mode on 100% is crazy. How do you even turn that on? Hat idea. Advice for a horse. Wait. What's the hat idea? Ooh, my gender reveal party. Two blown up babies fight each other, and the one who wins is the gender of my baby. Okay, that's a good idea. Throw knife at a dummy with whatever color the gender is, and that's how I find out because the color leaks out like blood. This one could be a little risky. Okay, I'm not a professional, but I'm gonna advise maybe not throwing knives at the gender reveal party. I get two fishes of different colors, and someone goes inside and flushes the color that is not my baby's gender, and the one standing is the gender of my baby, but I don't know if I'm keeping the fish. Just looked at the shot and someone said, girl, just make a cake with the color. Turtle got his balls cut off. He's unfertile. Turtle gonna make you speechless. He's gonna make you unverbal. Turtle is a leader. Just call him Colonel. Turtle plays Pokemon. His favorite is Squirtle. Turtle reads books, plays video games. He's a nerdle. Why me, why me, why me, why me, why me? JK, I'm over it. Because I don't care. I f***ing love the Kardashians. Okay, yeah, speak your truth. Right into the notes app. Adult to-do list. Go to dentist. Fix uterus. Get actual glasses. Go to doc and get updated with meds and brain care. Therapy, I guess. Therapy, I guess. Well, did you do it? Oh, actually, it looks like you didn't. None of them are checked off. Okay, jokes. Oh my God. Are you guys ready for my stand-up comedy routine? What part of the body dies last? The pupils, they dilate. Why is Santa's sack so big? Because he only comes once a year. Oh! Oh! Wait, that's actually a good one. I really like that one. What do you call a cheap circumcision? A ripoff. How do Legos separate themselves? They just Lego. Ooh. No one's, like, I can't hear any laughter, okay? I mean, I'm looking in the chat, I see some people writing ha ha ha, but I'm not gonna lie, you guys, I'm at my stand-up routine right now and it's feeling very awkward. No laughter out loud here. No, not a single chuckle or anything. It's really silent. I'm just getting uncomfortable, but I'm gonna keep going. What do you call someone who refuses to fart in public? A private tutor. Wait, this last one's actually crazy. Why does Dr. Pepper come in a bottle? Because his wife died. Yikes. Yeah. This is sit-down comedy. Hey, things happen. It was no one's fault. Me talking to myself after almost causing a head-on collision by going straight in a turning lane. I mean, hey, things happen. Ooh, this is deep, you guys. Having the internet is nice because you can connect with friends at any time, but sometimes it's hard to unconnect from that and be present. Am I addicted to my phone? Or the people in my phone. Whoa. People in my phone. Oh, be useless so that no one can use you. Oh. So real. Oh. Oh. This scared the f- out of me. I was like, what is that? What is that? What is that? But I know exactly what that is. Oh, look at these cute little pets. Look at these cute little pets. Gripping that butternut squash. Yep. What if every movie was something that happened in real life, but nobody knew? Everything I watch feels satire. Like, it's just a thing making fun of the way we act and the way we are. Like, what the f*** are we doing? We're alive by some phenomenon and we all decide to be assholes to each other and go to war and not just respect each other and move on? What if when we're high, we're experiencing the world as how it's supposed to be like? What? Okay, so you're stoned writing this, yeah? Ooh, my pet peeve list. Okay, let me see if I agree with any of these. Talking with food in their mouths. Yes. Annoying voice. That's what, that one's a little sad because I feel like they can't help it, you know? Dirty people. Yeah, I mean, when you can smell body odor, it's just a little, chewing loudly. That kind of like the same as the first one, right? Like, that's kind of the same as the first one. Drunk people. Yeah, it's a little it depends though. Like some people when they're drunk, they're like fun and funny, but some people when they're drunk, they're like, it's People that don't listen. Yeah. Screaming strangers. Hypocrites. Hypocrites. Liv told me about how she puts hand sanitizer in water to just get a little bit drunk. Oh my god. Why not just put like a little bit of alcohol in water to just get a little bit drunk? Like, gaslight. There's no way someone is submitting a list of gaslighting phrases. I'm a little bit scared of this person. I didn't do anything wrong. You're being dramatic. Believe what you want. Okay, don't believe me. It's always my fault. I mean, think what you want, but just know it's not true. Oh.
Ooh, what did you do?
What did you do?
This looks like a note to like a teacher.
Dear Mrs. Berman,
I am very, very sorry for my behavior today. It was disrespectful, rude, and disgusting. I will never be able to express how unbelievably sorry I am for my behavior in class today. I should have listened and been alert. I shouldn't have been goofing off, and I shouldn't have left class without your permission. I assumed it was okay, and I disrespected your authority, which is not okay. I should have asked you immediately before, as that takes away your power as a fantastic teacher and as an educator. Okay.
This is doing a little bit too, a fantastic teacher and an educator.
Gassing them up a little bit much here. I think AI wrote this.
I enjoy being in your class every day and I believe you are one of my favorite teachers I've had this year.
Oh my god. I can't. How is this kernel?
Ooh, men icks. Scooting down in a booth seat.
Smile more / wear my hug at. How is that an ick? How is that an ick, you guys? Come on.
You should smile more. Wear my hug at. Wear my hug at. Come on, wear my hug at. You should smile more.
This is not an ick. This is normal. Driving with both hands on the wheel. Okay, now this is just getting a little bit, this is a little bit nitpicky because that's the law, right? That's a, how are you gonna be safe. You're gonna be safe when you're driving.
Oh my god. Wait, patent this. Patent this.
Unfunfetti. Funfetti cake, but instead of sprinkles, it's thumbtacks. I think you're onto something here. Ooh, fun facts. This is great. You know, whenever you're like out with your friends and maybe there's like a lull in conversation, you gotta pull out your fun facts note.
Oh my god. My hashtag teen choice vote for choice female web star is Jen McAllister.
Oh my god. How cute.
You're a real one.
2016, you've got the tweet drafted in your notes app to vote for me for choice female web star.
Guys, I'm like 99% sure that this didn't matter. I hate to burst your bubble, but you know what? It matters to me that you did it. It matters to me that you did it because you are dedicated and supportive.
Ooh. I trusted you so f***ing much and gave you all my heart and f***ing soul. You were the first guy I ever called. You were the first guy I called daddy. And the first guy I ever thought about while listening to Lana Del Rey songs? Shut up.
And the first guy I ever sent hole pics to? No, this is f***ing crazy. Did you actually send the sex messages?
Ooh, times I've cried in 2023. Oh, wow.
Well, this is a really comprehensive list. Not only do you have the date, but you've also got the time. Like, the time it started.
So, wait, I need to know a little bit more detail about this. So, you start crying and then you immediately look at the clock.
Like, the first tear falls and your first thought is, oh, I gotta document this. What time is it?
And my next question is, what happened in March?
We've got almost daily here in March. Some days more than once as well.
Wait, what happened on February 3rd? The 1:04 to 5 a.m.
The 4-hour-long crying session that ended exactly at 5 a.m. The clock struck 5 a.m. and the tears dried. Oh my god, more baby names. Eek! Girls. Luna. Willow. Florence. Thea. Violet. Birdie Lou. Is this a Birdo sneak? Or am I just a Lulu? I'm Birdie Lou, DeLulu, I'm Birdie Lou. Theodora, Eleanor, boys, Elio, Finn, Winnie, Walter. I'm setting my kids up to be bullied. Definitely with Birdie Lou you are. I like how someone in the chat said Winnie is my dog's name because Finn is my dog's name. I love the name Finn, but because I've named my dog Finn, like I could never name like a son Finn. You know what I mean? Finn would always be a dog name to me. These are almost all dog names. Actually, yeah, a lot of them kind of do sound like they'd be dog names. You are right about that. Pet weights. Okay, yeah, you gotta keep this noted, you know. Mud pie. Mud Pie's so small. Mud Pie's only 1 pound. How sweet, little Mud Pie, so tiny.
Oh no! No!
What was going on in 2020? What were we doing? Oh my god. I'm not reading all that. Why does he do duck lips when he's mad? To-do list. Take bipolar meds. Talk to a therapist about inner monologue voice. Fix hair roots. Stop weed addiction. Wash clothes. Clean room. Set TikTok. What is... Random bitch. She did her homework. Oh. She did her homework. Oh. She did her homework, oh. She did her homework, oh. Oh my god. What is this? Ooh, band names. I love this. Bang Crisis. Yup. Cremation Society. Okay, I'm gonna see Cremation Society this weekend. Okay, yeah. Icy Bridge. Oh, did you hear that new Icy Bridge song? Okay, yeah, I hear that one. Deadhead Possum. Okay, yeah, like, let's go see Deadhead Possum. Okay. Synchronized Nosebleeds. Synchronized Nosebleeds. Did that come from... Where did that come from? Why does that sound so familiar? Do we have another note with that in it? No, it was from The Searches. It was from The Searches, from the search history submission form. And you did this on June 12th. Oh yeah, synchronized nosebleeds. New idea unlocked for the list, huh? Yeah, I'm seeing the band Synchronized Nosebleeds for sure. Oh. This is the craziest submission yet. Like what? why is this so far out? Becoming mask, adapt, or die. I want a little bit more information about this submission. Words for things. Sunny side up egg. Cooked eyeball. Water. Cloud juice. Cloud juice. Trademark that right now. Cooked eyeballs, a little scary though. Okay. I love the pictures and some screenshots. Okay, this is from 2015. Dear Diary, I wanted to say I hate school so much. So just make me smart now. I just want to FaceTime all day. Ugh, but I have a crush on 2 boys. So their names are redacted. But redacted used to love me, but I still like him. But he makes me cry, so Redacted loves Batman, so bye, see ya later. Sophie. Dear Diary, today is Sunday. Redacted and Redacted did not come. My text is broken and my FaceTime. Bye. Bye. Dear Diary, today was a normal day. Got breakfast, went to school, read, and so that was my day.
So I hate school. Bye. See ya. Do you ever get so completely terrified of death? Like, people have different definitions of death, but nobody knows for sure. Whoa. So I'm talking like genuinely never living again. Like, you're just another organism that's going to never experience life again. Makes me actually more scared than I have ever been, but it passes pretty quick and I... Yikes. Kind of a vibe killer. Weird things I'm scared of. Bathtub drains. Okay, I used to have a weird fear when I used to live in an apartment. I used to always have the fear that my bathtub and shower would fall through the floor into the apartment under me. I don't live in an apartment anymore, so that fear has been eradicated, but stop. Not someone in the chat saying that literally happened to my niece. No. No. That's freaking me out that it's actually something that happened. Unnecessarily specific things I hate. When people don't finish their sentences and move on to the next topic. When people interrupt you by saying, finish the sentence. Okay, that actually is so annoying. Sunrises. Okay, wait, actually I kind of get that a little bit because they just happen so early. You know what I mean? I'm not a morning person. It's like, sunrises happening so early in the morning. Like, that. Leos plus Cancers plus Gemini. Oh my God, I'm a Cancer. And okay, what do you have? You have something against people who have birthdays in the summer, huh? Because Gemini is June, Cancer's July, Leo's August. What's going on with the summer birthday hate here? Copycats, get your own personality. When trapped into a conversation that you so clearly do not want to be a part of. Oh yeah. The number three. What's wrong with the number three? I love that number. When people say you look tired, that's actually so annoying. It's like, maybe I am. Maybe I am tired. So we don't need to point it out, you know? Or maybe I'm not. And then in that case, we really don't need to point it out because... Total giveaway traits people have that prove they're a psychopath. Okay, putting ranch on anything that's not salad. Oh. Guys, I literally had a slice of pizza today for lunch and I dipped it in ranch. Not looking out the car window on a drive. Okay, yeah, that is a little psychopathic. Not watching trailers for films. Okay, wait, now you're getting, what? Okay, sometimes I feel like it's better to go into a movie without watching the trailer first because sometimes trailers give away too much of the movie. And to go in completely blind is kind of a vibe, okay? Uses overhead lights, that is psychopathic. I agree there, I agree there. Wearing jeans or sleeping in them. Who wrote these notes? I'm sitting in jeans right now. Okay, but I would never sleep in jeans. I would never sleep in jeans, I agree. Voluntarily taking a nap, I also agree with because I can't. Taking a nap, I feel like I wake up so much worse than how I started. Oh, a dream. Keith Urban came and I was his goddaughter. He said my room was messy and I would fix it. We bought a whole bunch of sparky clothes and he kept asking my opinion on his outfits. I'm really glad you wrote this down. I can tell you woke up 8:48 a.m. Grab your phone. You gotta write this down quick. And I'm really glad you did. Wait, this person is from the future, June 69th, 6969. Wow. White Ice Spice. 1:24 a.m. I know you have this shit, like, on your phone, pointing it at the DJ in the club. That's what's going on here. I'm 14.4% straight at 1 a.m. Bath and Body Works. Yeah, I sure hope it does. I don't want to use a broken bath. And of course, my body works. Okay, guys, we're gonna look at one final note today. There's still so many. I can't even believe how many submissions we got for this submission stream. But here is the last one for today's stream. No pressure, though. It better be good, because it's the last one, but no pressure. Dream I loose all my teeth, one by one, accidentally pulling one out first, then the others just start falling. No. Oh, this is a nightmare. Also, I love how you could tell this person literally woke up in a cold sweat. Like, you were definitely like sleeping and you woke up, you're like, at 1:35 in the morning and have to write this down as quickly as possible. Well, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this stream. Like I said, we still have so many more. So please let me know if you want me to do this again. We honestly have like endless amounts of content for note submission streams. So just let me know down in the comments below. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye, YouTube.